Hi, welcome back to another rapid update. This is your Iraq update. It is 8:37 p.m. on Tuesday, March 23rd in Baghdad. I'm sure everybody had a long weekend expecting some big news to come out of Iraq. There's still that possibility. However, if you are unaware of what's happening with the budget, it has been postponed to this coming Saturday, March 27th. But there is talk that negotiations are going quite well and things could be wrapping up prior to that. So let's take a look at what's going on in rapid form. This article just came out. The Kurdistan Democratic Bloc in Iraqi Parliament is likely to pass the budget in the session next Saturday. After reading this, they've indicated that positive results have been reached in the ongoing negotiations in Baghdad. This individual, head of the Kurdistan Bloc in the Iraqi Parliament, told the news, "We are still continuing discussions with political blocs on reaching an agreement on the federal budget, and the atmosphere so far is positive, and they do expect the law to be approved this coming Saturday." We all know that Nowruz holiday is just now concluding, and we had several days of celebrations there in the Kurdistan region, which happens to be Kurdistan's New Year. There is a lot of talk about the exchange rate right now, and this came out, a sudden decrease in the exchange rate of the dollar in Baghdad. Well, what kind of a decrease are we talking about? The exchange rate of the dollar gradually and suddenly decreased on Tuesday on the main stock exchange in Baghdad. How much? So it went from 1450 to 1415, or 141,500 Iraqi dinars per 100 US dollars. Also in the Central Kifa Stock Exchange, registered at 145,150 Iraqi dinars during its opening this morning. Let's move on to this passport. The Ministry of Interior reveals the specifications of the new passport that suits the reputation of Iraq. Here's what's really cool about this. This passport is developed and contains a special SIM card that carries information stressing that this passport is not subject to fraud. It's universally recognized and benefits the reputation of the Iraq. This passport will encourage investment in Iraq and facilitate and simplify procedures for companies and citizens who want to invest in Iraq. Anti-corruption. This is a great article. Just to hear what they just said about companies and citizens that want to invest in Iraq. Iraq is moving in the right direction, and I applaud them for that. Saleh, Iraq has not reached the stage of inflation and prices have not risen significantly. Saleh is the Prime Minister of Financial Affairs. He confirms on Tuesday that Iraq has not reached a stage of inflation, and we still within one decimal place. Before the adjustment of the dollar exchange rate, inflation in Iraq was slightly higher than zero. People are sensitive to prices on the basis of the commodity, but we believe that inflation is an indicator measure with weights, and every commodity has a relative weight, pointing out there is a commodity that may have risen 500%, but its relative weight is little compared to vegetables or foodstuffs. There has become a sense of prices after adjusting the dollar exchange rate, but it is still reasonable that inflation is still acceptable, not at the individual level, but at the level of general price index. So this is very interesting that they're talking about this. You know they're talking about this in their negotiations. They're bringing in experts. They're trying to, again, they're trying to figure out where the exchange rate is going to fall, or if it's going to be changed at all this coming Saturday. This is an opinion from Al Lidihad. I don't even recognize his name. Maybe you do. The differences with the Baghdad are minor and will be resolved before the date of the budget vote. So this is back to the beginning of the video. I said it could be resolved prior to Saturday. It very well could be. And this is, again, somebody's opinion saying, hey, things are going well. These discussions and developments are just coming down to final touches. Could we see a vote take place on maybe Thursday? Maybe. Hey, if you're liking rapid updates on Iraq and silver and gold and other topics, please give me a thumbs up. And as always, if you have a comment, comment below. Let's end it on this article. Representative Block, we will oblige the government to restore the exchange rate of the dollar to what it was previously. A lot of talk about what was previous. Well, to me, previous is what was on the CBI. What was it for several years before this devaluation? Was it 1190, 1190 on the CBI chart, or was it 1160? Okay, so again, this is Al Sadegan. Parliamentary bloc confirmed on Tuesday that Parliament will oblige the government to restore the exchange rate back to what it was previously. Then Fadel Al Fatlawi said Parliament will resort during the voting session on the budget to put forward the file on returning the exchange rate of the dollar against the dinar to what it was in the past in order to vote on it and oblige the government to implement it. This decision, which was issued by the Minister of Finance and the Central Bank of Iraq, was unsuccessful, and it negatively affected the lives of citizens as it contributed to the high price of all commodities, which led to difficulty in living, and this is what we will not accept in Parliament. These parliamentary blocs can pressure the CBI to make changes to the rate, but I don't think the CBI is going to just change. All right, that's going to do it for this rapid updates video. Remember, everybody, stay grounded, invest in yourself, and check out one of these videos in the top right corner. We'll see you on the next rapid update.